when I see stuff like this and people doing things like this, I get very inspired, and it makes me want to encourage and try to get people to be like, come on, let's roll with it and be about it for the Lord.
And so now you come as Paul is persecuting the church. He's on the road of Damascus. And as he's on the road of Damascus, he runs into Jesus Christ. What reigns in your mind a lot of times when you're busy, like, I don't have that time to give you no water. Do you see me working up here? I got all this stuff to do. All right, you can go back. Thank you. I got all this stuff to do. See? You see how
We headed to Loveland. Loveland Church. to take a watch this multimedia conference. Now that I'm getting a little bit older, I don't have time to be throwing around just hanging out just cause. You know, it has to be purposeful. I just wish I was younger and my time was more purposeful. I might be a little bit further along. You have to have purpose within your time. You know, it first started with the CSYC's California State Youth Conference Committee. That group puts on a lot of the youth events for the Church of Christ. So, you know, they were like, ah, we need some flyers and stuff. And so, you know, I presented some things. This was back in 98, 99, and so you know, ever since then, you know, I have been the go-to guy for the flyers in Southern California. It's been a little while since I've been doing this stuff. So for the most part, if it's a CSYC something, California State Youth Conference something event, then it's probably my flyer that I've created. Like Brother Garrett, back when we had the worship at the mountain, he would always want a t-shirt. Hey, brother, need one of them t-shirts. Can you give me one of them t-shirts? Can you need the design? We need a flyer. Hey, we need a design. And when he see this, he gonna be like, that don't sound like me. Yeah, dude. But
put that on Facebook.
Yeah, put that on Facebook. It's a pretty cool thing to see hundreds of kids with the same shirt on representing, you know, our religious institution. It's pretty cool to see. Some other events that I've created flyers for. The last big thing that the Church of Christ did, where it was the power of one, where we had all the churches of Christ in Southern California come through at this one event. That was Kevin Murray's brainchild. And he used to tell us about it. Unfortunately, being in his passing, we caught his wave after he passed away, and we were able to pull it off. So that ran for, 3 years, and, you know, created the shirt for that and the flyers and all the advertisement for that. And that was a pretty nice event. We probably should try to pick that up again one day, but, you know, we all in our little sections right now. So if the Lord wills, we'll be able to get it back on. And you need it because we're competing. We're not competing against one another. We're competing against Satan. And Satan, you know, is in these cell phones. Satan is just permeating throughout the land. So, you know, we gotta compete, man. If we don't compete, Christ will never get drowned out, but he will. He will. His voice will be diminished if you don't compete and try to do your thing. So that's, you know, that's why we, because if you look at the mega churches, they really be doing their thing. You know, as far as advertising and promotion and having the visuals and all that kind of stuff. So my motto is if it's not on Nike or Disneyland level, we playing. And everybody always want to look at me and like, Trey, why you always want to do the most? Well, if you want to win, they win it. Why can't we win? You know what I'm saying? be here for the Media Minds Conference at Loveland Church, and we're just watching the different presentations about media and movies and acting and things like that. My first sermon ever was at my grandmother's church, Penuel Baptist Church, and we were in Bible class, and the Bible class teacher was like, "Oh, you boys, next week you guys gonna come and give us a sermon." And we're like, "We don't know how to preach. What you mean give you a sermon?" It's like, "Y'all be ready and give us a sermon next week in the Bible class." And so then we showed up the next week, gave a little sermonette. And, you know, the sermon, you know, got kind of repetitive after a while. I was like, "Okay, that's good. Now you go sit down." So that was the first sermon. That was back when I was 11, 12, something like that. Now, my second first sermon was during chapel at ACU. Now, ACU would suspend class for a period so that you can go and worship. So you have the entire campus in the basketball arena worshiping during the worship period. And so the minister at the time, where we were going to North 10th and Treadway in Abilene, Texas, and the minister was J.K. Hamilton. So I think his name was John Hamilton and J.K. Hamilton. He approached me and was like, "I need somebody to preach during chapel." He's like, "You want to preach?" And I'm like, "I ain't never preached." He's like, "Yeah, preach during chapel. It's not going to be that long." He convinced me to preach during chapel. And so I developed a little 15-minute sermonette and got up in front of all those kids and preached for 15 minutes. I forget what the sermon was about, but I know it had fire in it. You're going to catch on fire, because something about some catch on fire, that's what sticks out in my mind. Catch on fire, you're going to catch on fire. And so that was a horrible sermon. I'm very hard on myself. That was a horrible sermon. I believe that
we need to get some gas, or I'm gonna be pushing.
I believe that God is in the message, because you derive your sermon from His inspired word. So therefore, when you are preparing the messages, the word is in there. But the problem comes is the person who delivers it. Some people are more exuberant, more expiring, and that kind of thing. That's the issue right there. It's almost, and if I can liken it to like comedians, some comedians are better than others based upon their, what God has gave them as far as physical talents, their innate talents, their facial expressions, their voice, their tonals. Of course, you can develop those things when you practice and, you know, do it for a while, but if you were to just give a straight word of God, like I walked up to somebody and says, "You know, the Lord loves you and you need to be saved and He has some healing power." That's the Holy Spirit. Just me, the Holy Spirit working within me to say that is the Holy Spirit working, because the average man is not going to speak that or say that or even believe that. But when I say it, it's because the Holy Spirit is influencing me to do so. But me critiquing it, that's me myself critiquing myself, because I'm hard on myself. And I have other people in my mind that are my litmus or my standard bearer, like Martin Luther King, another standard bearer, Jack Evans. How he deliver and how I deliver, I got a lot of work to do.
A few moments later.
Do you see this? They have abundant living truck. I brought my comrade Chris over to Abundant Living to kind of demonstrate the vision that I have for our religious institution, which is the Church of Christ. I always be on this stuff about we need to raise our game, step up our level, do more, be about more. And, you know, when we are in our little bitty box, people act like they don't know what I'm talking about. So I go outside the box, and lo and behold, a whole big old religious center campus. These dudes got banners. All this is them. This is crazy. It is very inspiring because for a long time, people used to kind of kick me and kind of belittle me and like, oh, you on extras. Why you think like that? Why you always want to? But when I see stuff like this and people doing things like this, I get very inspired, and it makes me want to encourage and try to get people to be like, come on, let's roll with it and be about it for the Lord.